And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek The Next Generation Echoes from the Past. I'm the RPG chick. Let's gather up my people. Annoying controls. All that kind of thing. We need to go back to engineering. We can turn these lights back on. I just burned a half hour. I thought I was recording and I wasn't. And I was wandering around. Hopefully I have better luck this time. We need to go south at some point to wherever is not a dead end, which leads us back to engineering. And then we get lights back on and it won't look all reddish like this with emergency power. So I did look up a walkthrough, like I promised you guys I would be. I don't want to mess around with this crap forever. It's boring for you to watch. Not as if it's not boring enough. I mean, it's really... They walk slow and we're not really accomplishing anything quickly. But here... Oh, we got these. I can't forget these. We need all of these we can get. Yeah, might as well have Worf get them. So here... Go these things. Power transfer conduits. You notice there's, well, if I move him... Yeah, there's two missing. They go in there. Or bloop. Wait. There is two places to put it. Yay! Now there's color and stuff. Now it doesn't look like we're playing on an amber monitor except all red. Magenta. Now we have some other things to get. I didn't notice down here. This is actually the med bay. We need these. And we need these. More optical things. The robots are down there, but we don't need anything from them. But just for the hell of it, I'm going to blast this with extreme prejudice. They're down there. Down this way. There's nothing down there, though, so... I'm not gonna mess with them. I'm missing a crew member. Well, you know, screw her. Oh, here she is. Come with us. Here's the shuttle bay. Oh, wait. Don't even. More optical stuff. And, naturally in the shuttle bay, you'd find a shuttle. And if you analyze it, it says shuttlecraft. Really, no need to go all out with that. Those are empty. Nice small rooms, I like them. Not really so much so with this room. So I've played this, not only have I seen a walkthrough, but I've played through this whole freaking thing. And thought I was recording and I really wasn't. Wasn't talking to you guys, I was just talking to myself. Gotta love when that happens. So I'm actually, you know, happy in itself just to be playing a Sega Genesis game. Genesis was one of my favorite consoles growing up. In fact, it was my favorite console. It's just I could never finish a game on it. Except for one. I got substantially far in Phantasy Star 3 and 4. Love to play those again. As well as... dead end. There is stuff in here to find. So I'm not leaving until I get there. I can get through... Alright, never mind. Yeah, I've been here. We need to go through here. Shining in the Darkness was another good one. That was a really cute, interesting game. That's a pressurization pump. And these are more optical thingies. And I think that's it. I don't know if I can get to that side of the room. But I'll try. Oh, I can. Ah. Not sure we need that one. So yeah, as you can see, pressurization pump, more optical circuits. That's liquid strontium. I think we do need that one. We end up having three of them. Dinitrous coolant and ionic vivium. I know we need the ionic vivium. I think we need the strontium as well. Not completely sure, but we will find out because we match the symbols is what it is. That's actually one of the last things we do. So now I need to command again so everyone comes with me. I think we have to fight a robot in one more area. That's it. And I keep my Starbucks Frappuccino glass bottle beverage is blocking my view to the left corner of the screen, which you guys can't see, but is an indication that we are recording, and I want to keep looking at that because, yeah, that's disappointing to play for. I was playing for like 25 minutes and I'm like, then I went to stop recording and it said it was starting, recording has been started, and I'm like, what? Now, even when I played last time, I missed some circuits. So we're done in this area for now. We gotta put all the circuits in there, obviously. So the one game, yeah, I forgot to keep talking about that. The one game I did finish is called Dungeons and Dragons Warriors of the Eternal Sun. So here we have already have a pressurization pump. I guess that one's there, giving us a little hint that, yeah, it helps us get through the doors or something. Because we have to place this by another set of doors. So yeah, believe it or not, it's a Western RPG for a console. Not a JRPG. Very rare indeed. Alright, we've got everything from here. This is the cryogenic sleep chambers. So I actually was able to finish that game because I had so much fun fighting lizard men and kobolds and stuff. The lizard men were freaking awesome. They had a little temple and they all just freaking like swarmed out of there like a bunch of ants and attacked. It really filled my mind with a sense of awe back then. So I'd love to play that again. So I ended up, I love fighting so much, I end up just grinding without even meaning to, because I'm like, yeah, at some point I'll you know, go into the dungeons, because that, like, I think going into the dungeons advanced the plot or something. You know, you have a quest there to do. We're in the bridge. This is the bridge. And there's nothing to find in a bridge. So let's get the hell out of the bridge. This is a really neat game. And then the overland areas, you had basically like a top-down, I'm not quite sure if you could call it isometric, but it was a top-down view, And then once you're in the, which was turn-based, once you're in the dungeons, it was like Dungeon Master. It was a first-person view, you know, 3D-ish kind of. Let me put the pressurization pump. And yeah, it was real time, you know, first person in dungeons. That was pretty neat. This one is the one I missed on my playthrough. This vertical one here. We don't need the other one, but I'm just gonna get them all. Break through the cracks there. So that, unless you put that pressurization pump here and get into this room, you're not putting the computer back online, and you're not finishing this game. You're not finishing this area of the game. Now, we may or may not have all the pieces we need at this point. And I don't know how to get the hell out of here. Okay. Oh my god, they walk so slow and you don't know they're walking into a dead end. South, man! Want to go south! Can we leave and stuff? Oh my god. This is where I... Wait. That's the secret room. Okay, I would like to leave this area now. Maybe I need to go all the way around this crap. Oh. It wasn't south that we needed to go, it was east. Go east, young Klingon! Okay, this is where the horizontal one that we picked up just goes. Now that'll be the first one I put in. So you can figure out from, you know, the way it's supposed to go. Ta-da! This has like a two... I can't tell which character I'm controlling because they all move. This goes here. This one's a straight horizontal one. I have a feeling Data has that, yeah. Oh, stop that. Oh. The hell are you doing? No. Oh. Because I have Data, damn it. I think I'm looking at Worf. You guys probably understood what happened. There's nothing to put because I'm not even on anything. There's nothing to take, rather. Horizontal one goes there. Worf has the double one, I think. The double rainbow. Or Data. Right. Worf did have it, but Data took it out, so... Data can move his little butt over there and put it in. And boom, two more. This one, I think... Yes. Yay! Okay, we've got all the pieces in. Engineering, I think, is directly south. Good thing, guys, I save after every LP episode. Because I was just, you know, I was saving all the way when I wasn't recording. But I was saving under LP, you know, number three. Slot three. So here we go. I keep hitting the wrong button. Sorry, guys. Right. This one takes the ionic vivium. You can see we're matching up the symbols. Bloop. Now. This is what I couldn't figure out last time. If there's an order to these switches. And I'm sorry, my voice is very hoarse. It's not a horse, but it's hoarse. Oh, because I have Worf. Keep forgetting that. Okay, now let's save. It'll be a lot quicker this time because I knew what I was doing. So it actually, in turn, makes a more interesting episode. But no, I'm not going to play every episode first and then record it the second time. That'd drive me insane. Three, so save. Okay. And the monkey flips the switch. Nothing seemed to happen. I have the right one in there? me just look. Looks like... yeah, it's definitely not that one. Actually, there's no more robots, so Data can command again. Maybe he has to flip the switch, because he's actually in command, I don't know. Because the switch is already flipped. Okay, main engine online, and this is when it wouldn't stop. Engineering. Switch. Pressurized gas inlet. Now, according to what I read, we're supposed to be beamed up now. Or maybe we beam ourselves up. The vessel is still in trouble. Maybe we've managed to get its computer online. It will help. Energize. I'm missing something. Sorry about that, guys. It's cracking my knuckles. Data is commanding. Please to come with. Maybe we need to do something else with the computer. This is what I couldn't figure out last time. Is there another switch to... Okay. I think what I need to do is change these. This is bridge? Is that where I am? Bridge. Sorry, guys, this is annoying to watch and it's annoying to walk around in. This is computer room. Yes, we need to go over here. Something is messed up here. See, look, these are identical. Well, it doesn't fit. One horizontal one. Can't be this one. thinking that should be a straight horizontal one. Okay, Data has all of them now. I guess us beaming up and down, or we just happen to use all the ones that Worf used. Worf had. Can't be this one, right? No. It just, it seems to make sense to me, so I'm trying nonsensical things. You'd think it was this one. Really, right? Nope. Keep thinking that maybe something hooks up in a way we didn't expect. Oh wait, away team to Enterprise. Ship's systems operational. Energize. Now I really want to watch back the video and see what's so different about that last tile. Seriously. We're being hailed. On screen. Ah, here's a jovial looking fellow with a big forehead and nose. Greetings, I am Caesar Jarak of the Eunacian people. We would like to offer a token of our gratitude for rescuing our crippled ship. We are happy to help other people. We seek no other reward for doing our duty. We are the USS Enterprise. Yeah, we are the USS Enterprise, representatives of the United Federation of Planets. Are your vessel systems operational? So we'll just neither confirm or deny that they can give us stuff. Yes, they are. Due to extensive hull damage, however, our humble craft will be unable to achieve its mission goal. Our 10,000-year voyage from the Gamma Quadrant has come to this. How foolish to assume that our people were ready for the test of the IFD. I know, man, that IFD. What is that mission goal? You will face many more tests in rediscovering a galaxy very different from your native one. In the event of difficulties, seek out the nearest Federation starbase, which will be glad to be of service. I want to know what the mission goal is. What is that mission goal? Ah, you toy with us. We are indeed worthy of ridicule. Well, for your kindness, please accept this tavad. Primitive, I'm sure, to aid your fine people at the time of the test. Our test is simpler. To live. Test? To what test are you referring? I can hear Picard saying these lines. What does this tavad do? Alright, with it. Yeah, what does it do? We don't know what the test is. He's only going to think we're making fun of him. What does the tavad do? Do not worry, Captain. A complete diagnosis has been performed, and all of its systems are still operational. For what purpose? What is this test you mentioned? The test! To see whether you're worthy to use the IFD, the most powerful device in the universe. Soon you will have the chance. The IFD. The Unity device? Well... I can't see how anything would be more powerful than the Unity device. See previous game, Star Trek The Next Generation, a final Unity. soon we will have the chance. I've heard a little about the IFD. Most of our scholars consider it to be a myth. Well, what do you mean by soon? Compared to a 10,000-year journey, this all sounds so mythical. Alright, most of our scholars consider it to be a myth. A myth in your culture, a reality in ours. 10,000 years ago, in the far-off Gamma Quadrant, our race passed the test. We ruled the galaxy briefly, but found it too awesome a responsibility. The Stavad will help you when the IFD arrives. Good luck, and may you represent liberty and justice at the moment of truth. Out. Huh. Well, I am at a loss. Let's answer this hail. Ah, it's Admiral Alec Baldwin. That delivery to Orion's Alpha 4 is long overdue. What in blazes are you up to? We are aware of the urgency, Admiral. We encountered a derelict ship with lifeforms aboard. A derelict ship, do you say? Could you make contact? Yes, after restoring the ship's power, the ship couldn't correct itself because its occupants were in hibernation. Or, affirmative, the ship's captain gave us a device. He says, yeah. Okay, affirmative. The ship's captain gave us a device he says will be useful when something called the IFD arrives. A myth, I had thought. Interesting. I'll look into it. You trust them? I was going to say, I'll trust you, look into it. Implicitly, yes. But 10,000 years is a long, long time. What? Why do we trust them implicitly? That's foolish to say. I'm going to say this. They seem sincere, but I'm not entirely confident of their story. Has there been any development among the Romulans? No, just more of the same. Ships are zipping here and there for now. It's hard to make out the little diamond-shaped periods from the commas. For now, make that delivery to the folks on Orion's Alpha 4. Out! I guess I'm having trouble reading all this crap. Plot a course for Orion's Alpha 4 immediately. You must delay no longer. Alright. Helmsman? Plot a course for Orion's Alpha 4. Warp 6.2. Engage. And here we are. You're being hailed. On screen. I love it. I don't know why I love it. Oh, cool! He looks like a cross between Merlin and a ninja. Federation vessel, at long last you arrive. Starfleet informed us that you would be here long ago. Many thousands are on the brink of death. Luckily, your timely arrival has saved them from such a fate. Out. You're welcome? Captain's log. In accordance with Starfleet quarantine regulations, the necessary medical supplies have been beamed directly to the surface to avoid direct physical contact between the crew and those on the planet below. The Enterprise is now returning to its previous duties. Which, I guess, is to aimlessly wander the quadrant for whatever until something happens. Oh, we are being hailed. I guess something's happening. Enterprise. Yes, it's Adam Baldwin again. We've just received a distress signal from Orion's Gamma 3B, a mining moon. They've gotten themselves into quite a jam inside the mine. Be careful. That moon is not a very friendly place. It's rich in polentium and ravarium, both highly radioactive. No other information is available? No, it was only a distress beacon, and there is another matter altogether. Long-range sensors have detected several unauthorized penetrations of the neutral zone. Do you suspect the Romulans? Well, we don't know what to make of it. Whatever they are, they don't leave warbird sensor tracings, but they came from the Romulan direction. Perhaps it's an entirely new class of Romulan ship. Has intelligence given any indication of that possibility? The Romulans are always working on some new plan, which the Klingons don't appreciate much. They've contacted us about this matter. Oh. What's their analysis? Oh, they see smoke and mirrors from the Romulans, but I'm not thoroughly convinced. If it's an attack, it's too blunt. Too straightforward. Trying to make an attack that seem unlike an attack at all. Or... Well, we have to do that other thing, so I'm not going to jump on investigating that. Agreed. The Romulans trying to make an attack seem unlike an attack at all. That's right. But those ships won't reach our side of the neutral zone for some time. Get to those folks on Orion's Gamma 3B. Baldwin out. Okay, guys. So we'll head there next episode. Thanks so much for watching and enduring. Grow strong.